What's up guys, Davis here back with another video. I'm today going to be comparing these two phones, the Infinix Note 10 versus the Samsung Galaxy SE in the speed test and RAM management rate. So yeah guys, if you're new to my channel, please help me and subscribe, and if you end up liking what you see in the video, give me a thumbs up. Yeah, so let's get into the test right on. First up is phone. That was slightly faster on the Infinix. Messages, first on the Infinix. Camera, first on the A8. Gallery, about the same. Zenda, okay, opens up first on the Infinix. Gmail, first on the Samsung. Photos, yeah, about the same, I guess. YouTube, first on the Infinix. WhatsApp, about the same. GG, about the same. Instagram. Okay, yeah, I'll open up first on the Infinix, maybe just because they have any feed to load, right? Okay, I think it'll be comparable, about the same. Spotify. Great, I think it does about the same. Bullet Force. Now did the games. First down, the Infinix. Asphalt Nitro. First down, the S8. Let's go. DLS 21. Well, I'll let you guys be the judge for that one. I'm not so sure which one opened faster. And I think it was just about the same. Split seconds difference. Temporan. That was first on the S8. Right. The S8 is still having some advantage when it comes to these heavier apps. S8 is still really good. Right, so let's go ahead and test out the RAM management. So they both have 4GB of RAM. Yeah, so real quick, I'll start up with the games, because ideally they will test the RAM better than the other lighter apps. So let's go Bullet Force. But still have it in the background. Asphalt Nitro. Alright. And DLS. Okay, so the Samsung reopens DLS. Okay, let's see Temporan. Samsung reopens Temporan. So yeah, I think I would see Tecno performing better when it comes to RAM. They both have 4GB RAM. Yeah, but Tecno looks like it performs better. So let's just pick one app randomly. These other simple apps. Let's open GC and see. Okay, looks like both of them still have it in memory. Gmail. Okay, both of them reopen. Great. This is Spotify. Looks like it reloads on both. Yeah. So yeah, that's about the speed test. And if I was to do a general comparison, I would say that okay, starting off with the display. Say the display on the A8 is a better one, certainly. It is sharper, you have better viewing angles. maybe the Infinix has advantages in terms of size, 6.9 versus about 5.9 inches, yeah, about 5.9 inches versus the 6.9. So yeah, if a person likes big phones, the Infinix is the one for you, no doubt. And when it comes to camera, I'll say front-facing camera, they're about the same. Okay, they're about as, in certain situations, one will be better than the other, but I'm not saying that one has a clear-cut edge over the other. Like maybe I'll say in video quality, they say it is still better, certainly. When it comes to the rear-facing cameras, well, I would say the Galaxy S8. Yeah, Galaxy S8 has better video quality at the back. And then the photos, yeah, they trade blows. None of them is really clear-cut, better. Either way, this has more cameras at the back, and this has a single firing camera at the back. But the other cameras on the Infinix don't really make that much of a difference. Maybe the macro camera, but how often are you taking macro shots anyway? Yeah. Then when it comes to the speakers, I'll say the speakers on the Infinix are better. Even has a stereo speaker setup. Yeah. Then software wise, so the Infinix is better because it has Android 11 versus the Android 9 on the AC. Yeah, so I think that's about that for this comparison. Battery life, Infinix is better definitely. So yeah, I think that's it for the comparison, and thank you guys for watching, and see you in the next one.